search. Tracking. Agent located.
This is Bob Ho.
Secret Agent Bob Ho has taken down dictators, terrorists, and evil empires. But he's about to face his toughest assignment yet. Babysitting.
You know, Cyrus, there was a time when I thought living next door to Jackie Chan would be a really cool thing. But looking at this movie, I don't know now.
It still could be if that happened in real life. This is clearly not real life. I'm afraid I'm the one who took the shrunken on this one. Oh, shit, he's Chinese, not Japanese. I apologize, but...
I don't think enough people know that much detail about Asian culture to even correct you.
Hell, I probably even said it wrong, so it doesn't really matter.
Most people are like, what do you say? So most people are like, Gesundheit.
Throwing star, okay? But yeah, this is Jackie Chan doing what Jackie Chan's been doing lately, which is making kids' films, which is fine, except it seems that every action star that was big in the 80s, that's all they're doing now.
I know, I heard the next Rambo movie is going to be like rated G.
Yeah, right? You know, at this point, I wouldn't be all that surprised.
Yeah.
It was like Rambo and Sesame Street versus the evil alphabet monster.
Yeah,
you know?
And Rambo's going around giving hugs, even, you know. He's an environmentalist.
V is for Vietnamese.
I love you, Rambo. It's a little chat Chinese Elmo.
R is for rice patty.
R is Elmo Chinese. I don't know. He might be.
It's hard to say.
It's hard to tell.
Yeah, his voice is so high, he might have a heavy accent.
He might be a midget black crackhead. I don't know.
He's
actually
a Russian. You can't tell.
Hey, comrade.
He's always eating the bowls of borscht over there. What is that smell? It's Elmo's breakfast.
But yeah, a lot of action stars, as you say, they're doing a lot of kids' movies these days. I mean, we had Vin Diesel who moved up to that. The Rock.
Yeah. The days of the iconic action star, like the name action star who just delivers one movie like that after another, are over. I mean, they really are, at least as far as America is concerned. There's still stuff like Tony Jaa and stuff going on overseas, but here, man, it's self-parody at all.
Yeah, it makes you appreciate somebody like Clint Eastwood a little bit better.
Yeah, it certainly does.
Because Clint Eastwood come into a kid's movie and the kids were like, hey, I'm going to get your fucking ass away from me.
That would be... You know what? There probably is a movie like that and I just can't think of it, but I'm going to pretend there isn't.
You little fucking rugrat kicking kids across, shooting them.
But you know, I'm going to do something odd here that I never do, and I'm going to start off with my rating because I'm going to be working backwards from that because
it's
I'm
like
going to be sounding very positive about this film because you guys are going into this already determined it's going to be bad. I mean, come on, you guys, be honest with yourselves. It's Jackie Chan, the spy next door. You're looking at Jackie Chan with a bunch of little kids hopping around doing Jackie Chan stuff with cartoony shit going on. You are determined to not like this movie from the get-go, most likely.
And I'm going to let you run with this. Can I just something just caught my eye right before we started.
Yeah.
Can I give you a list of what this director has done, Brian Levant?
Go ahead.
Okay, it's just one hit after another, man. Let's see.
What's he got? It can't be too bad, right?
Problem Child 2.
Ooh.
Jingle All the Way.
Ooh.
The Flintstones in Viva Rock Vegas.
Oh man, God, I don't think I can take anymore.
Snow Dogs, which I heard was all right.
Actually, I heard that was all right. Yeah.
Are We There Yet?
And, that was not all right.
That was patently bad. Yeah, and then Scooby-Doo, The Mystery Begins, which is actually for TV. So,
not a strong resume. Not the worst ever. I mean, certainly like only the Viva Las Vegas is that one that's so bad that he should have been prevented from working again. Because honestly, like Lisa said, Snow Dogs, people have said, generally wasn't that bad. Are We There Yet was really bad, but it wasn't like the I want to shotgun you to the face type of bad. And what was the one before Viva Las Vegas?
Viva Rock Vegas.
Viva Rock Vegas, whatever the hell. I'm not going to flinch.
Jingle All the Way is not
that terrible.
There's the one where it's Schwarzenegger versus Sinbad.
Yeah, and it's bad, but it's not so bad you can't watch it.
And for kids out there, we're not talking about the swashbuckling Sinbad. We're talking about the black comedian Sinbad.
Kids don't know the swashbuckling Sinbad. There's no Sinbad.
I guess they would know black Sinbad before him. So
you kids who love Ray Harryhausen, Jason and the Argonauts.
What band is he in? But okay, I'm sorry. Yeah. Now, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt them. I'll let you take the stage here.
That's okay. Please. It's the spotlight.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, and what's that speech Linus gives in Charlie Brown Christmas? No, never mind. I'm not going to do that.
All I know is, ooh.
I knew you'd know the music. I'm surprised you didn't know the speech.
No.
But you know me, I can't quote from the Bible.
I think Linus's speech was, you're a blockhead, Jesus.
But I'm going to start off with my rating. Like I said, this is a rental. Okay. I mean, there's no question it's a rental. Now, you're asking yourself, why isn't it some old bullshit? Well, honestly, I was surprised. It's not a great movie by any stretch of the imagination, and it's not directed at anyone but little kids.
Mm-hmm.
But it's tolerable to people who actually like Jackie Chan, which is a big surprise because outside of the Forbidden Kingdom, it's the first movie in like a decade he's done in America that actually had fights worth watching. I mean, like I said, this is like Jackie Chan with really annoying three little brats who are, you know, not even really that good actors. They're made into the most horrible children, except for the youngest one. The two others are like, man, you just would be like, fuck it. I don't even want to be here.
No.
Like, Chan in this is pretending to be a pen salesman who is ready to propose marriage to his next door neighbor, this hot blonde lady who's got the three kids, lots of pets.
Played
all
by
that.
Amber Valletta.
Yes. Only thing she doesn't know is he's a big spy with a Chinese Secret Service. I'm embarrassed to say I don't even know what their Secret Service is called. Who's on loan to the CIA and mm-hmm. has been here for a couple of years to close a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was it. He's like, you know what? I'm retiring because I want to have a family. I want to settle down with these people. Only problem is that the big bad guy who he's finally caught, you know, we see the little end of that mission, gets away almost instantly. And so the agency is like, well, we know you're retired, but any help you could give us on this? I'm retired. I'm retired. I don't want to. I can't do accents.
I was about to say that's French.
Yeah, I can't do it. I can't do accents.
I think you offended both the Chinese and the French
you
just then.
Edit it in so it sounds like me.
Oh, I'm just racist when I do it. I do Elmo.
I'm a Chinese spy.
I can do it if it's a Eddie Murphy routine or something. You want fortune cookie?
you want pen? I pen salesman.
There you go. But she doesn't know he's dead. She has to leave town all of a sudden. He goes, you know what? I'll take care of the kids, thinking that, you know what? No matter, my career as a spy is over. What could possibly go wrong? Well, thank God something does, because otherwise this would have been a horrible series of babysitter jokes.
Yeah, George Lopez and Billy Ray Cyrus show up.
Yeah, George Lopez and Billy Ray Cyrus are two guys who...
Oh, I was joking.
Oh, no, they actually do. Okay. Wow, that was amazing. You just picked that out of the ether
I'm just clairvoyant like
could
that.
Could have been anyone.
Yeah, it could have been anyone. No, I'm looking at IMDb
right now. It's still better than Sinbad, to be fair. But
you're the best agent I've ever had.
Hey, you know, I'm standing right here.
Maybe I can get your government to loan you to me just a little bit longer.
No, this was my last assignment. I'm retiring.
Don't tell me because of Jillian.
I want a normal life. I want to get married.
Oh, heck, man, don't get married. Just find some woman that you're going to hate in 5 years and give her your house.
I could never give up this life for a woman. We're spies, man. Every little boy wants to be a spy. It's the life. All the hours you spend sitting alone in a little room like this, eating cold takeout food in the back of a surveillance van, getting shot at all the time, you're doing the right thing.
Only problem is that her kids hate me.
You're the man.
Really gonna miss you, Ho. Good luck with those kids.
I brought down dictators. How tough can three kids be?
It does almost seem like this director is just like, huh, who can we get that no one gives a shit about in action movies?
George Lopez and Billy Ray Cyrus.
I love, you know, I mean, hell, James Cameron pulled it off with Roseanne's ex-husband, so.
Oh, that's true. True Lies.
Yeah, I guess you never know. But, you know, those guys, honestly, just forget about them. They really have almost nothing to do with why you would care or not care about this movie, and they're barely in it. Point is that Billy Ray Cyrus sends him a file to look over, like an encrypted file. When he's taking – Jackie Chan is taking care of these kids, the boy of the group, the middle kid, thinks it's a music file and downloads it to his iPod. The villains detect that someone has downloaded this file and are starting to come after him because, you know, tracing the file. So basically, he's trying to protect these kids. Mom's out of town. Bad guys everywhere. And he's trying not to let the kids know that he's a super secret agent, which doesn't last all that long. Okay, it's tedious setup. We've seen it a billion times. The movie makes almost no attempts to cover up giant gaping plot holes that pop along so often you could drive a James Bond's Aston Martin through them. But it's inoffensive. There's not a single belch joke. There's not a single fart joke. There's not a single poop joke. In a movie with a really little kid in it, you'd think that those were the type of things that we were going to have to deal with.
Yes,
here.
Sir.
It never hits that level of bottom rung of comedy. It's just not that funny. But what is great, and I mean great, are the fights. sure, we can tell it's not always Jackie Chan anymore, but the man's going on, what, 60 now, I think, you know?
You say he's got a hip double.
Exactly. There's some stuff that is obviously genuinely him, but a lot of the time, it's another guy. It's edited well enough, you can't tell that much unless you really look for those sort of things like me, because I'm kind of a martial arts freak. But they're good. They're inventive. They're really well choreographed fights. Like, they remind me of the old school Jackie Chan when he was constantly just using whatever prop was at hand and just fast and furious flying things at people. I mean, it's fun to watch. The movie picks up to where you sit straight up in your chair every time there is, in fact, a fight or a stunt sequence in it. And that was something I didn't expect at all. Because, like I said, he hasn't done anything this fun to watch as far as that goes since, yeah, well, hell, like I said, except for Forbidden Kingdom for about 10 years, most of his American films, you watch him and you're just like, wow, this is embarrassing. It's like this director doesn't know how to film an action scene.
Yeah. Anybody remember The Tuxedo?
Yeah. Great example.
Oh, what was that one movie where him and some chick, the end of the movie, had them flying towards the screen?
Oh, I know what you're talking about, but I can't remember. Yeah, but yeah, well, that's
because
they've all been completely unmemorable. This is actually worth seeing if you're a fan of Jackie Chan because of those scenes. They're fun to watch. They're creative. Now, I think it becomes clear at the end of the movie when they do, in fact, do the whole bloopers sequence, and almost none of them are action bloopers, that he did very little of his own action at points. You know, you're like, huh, these are all talking bloopers. In the old days, it was always like, oh, that guy just broke his face. Look, Jackie Chan's ankle, it just snapped in half.
Yeah, nowadays, it's like Jackie Chan doesn't have enough money to pay for his adult diapers at the cash register.
Well, it's the same with, like, the woman hits him in the chest with a bottle of bleach, and he's like, you know, she hit him a little too hard, and in the bloopers he's like, oh god, oh, you're like, the chick just hit you, what is that?
Hey man, he's up there, you know.
Yeah, you know, he is getting up there, and he hides it well for the sake of the production, and you know, kudos to the director, because he certainly doesn't look his age at all in this film.
Yeah, no, Jackie Chan is, hey look, compared to the normal person, because Jackie Chan was super powered at one time, I believe.
Oh, yeah, there was something going on in his physiology that was not human.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And he just, I mean, you know, he's still mortal, though. The guy can still probably beat the shit out of any of us.
Yeah, you would not want to fuck with him at all.
No, he's like Spider-Man.
He kind of is.
Yeah.
He is one of my heroes. Jackie Chan really is. I never could have grown up that way. That guy went through the Peking Opera School where they pretty much broke his hips so he'd be more flexible when he was like 5.
What?
Oh, you've never watched any of this stuff about the Peking Opera School?
They broke his hips?
No, that was what they would. They would push you down into your pelvis.
Fuck!
Yeah, really messed up stuff like that. I mean, essentially child abuse, but hey.
Jesus Christ.
Culture, and he's clearly not looking back with any sort of resentment.
No child protective services there.
No, they just throw him into the Peking Opera School. Your parents are abusing you.
I hate to say it, you know.
You're going to the movies.
Yeah. I know everybody's expecting me to make jokes about black mamas now, but really, they weren't that bad.
Well, you know, I mean, I don't tell you.
Wow.
I didn't say anything bad about China, per se. It's just a very, very, very foreign culture in a lot of ways, especially 50-some years ago.
So if you want to beat your kids, put them in the Chinese opera.
Yeah, well, you know, you think military school is bad.
I know.
Watch out, your parents threaten to throw you in there. You better behave.
I'm sending you to the Chinese opera. Fuck, okay. I'll clean my room.
You can end up being a badass like Sammo Hung or Jackie Chan or Jet Li, who all went through this, you know, and turned. That's, you don't think the guys like that got that just through, like, you know, in their 20s, they suddenly go, you know what, I think I want to learn martial arts. These guys know it that well because they've been doing it since they were old enough to spell.
Wow, I'm so sorry about talking about Jackie Chan. I mean, about him being old, because like most people, they break their hips at like, what, 75, you know, he got his out the way at 5. So maybe that's why he's so young now. He's like, well, you ain't got to worry about that.
That guy's broken like almost every bone in his body. He like split his skull open on an Operation Condor Armor of God 2. I mean, like literally where they thought he was going to die and preserved it on film so you could see it during the end credits.
Jesus, one day that guy's just going to like melt into like a pile of flesh. No bones are going to be able to hold him up.
Yeah, well, the robot exoskeleton will come out marching out. You know, I wouldn't be surprised at this point. But no, Jackie Chan, it's a pleasant reminder that he still is kind of a badass. And that, make no mistake, people, he was always a physical comedian. He's always been doing goofy, silly stuff.
Oh, yeah.
It's not surprising that he's doing these kids' movies. It's just that this is slightly better than the ones he's done before. Like I said, the plot is insipid and stupid as hell. Most of the acting is really bad. The villains, You know, you're like, really? These are the villains? They're just pathetic. There's nothing even mildly threatening about them at any point.
They're like the Three Stooges.
Yeah, something. Pretty much. But there is one bright point. Is the actress who plays sort of the female head flunky.
I got a name
villain.
Right here. Catherine Bosher.
Oh, my God.
I was looking at her, boy. I spread her on a piece of toast in a minute. I
like
her. They
just packed her into this, like, evil chick black suit she's wearing with a big push-up bra and cleavage, and I was like...
I'd love to pack her with something black right now.
Man, that was... Every time she... Yeah, I bet you would. Every time she was on screen, I was like, this is not a kid's film right now, at least not with what's going on in my head.
Not the Bob's head, not the movie in your head. Not the motion picture going on in your mind.
Yeah, there was some motion, all right. Damn.
But, man, no, you know what? Yeah. Actually got me wanting to see this movie, even though you got me wanting to like kidnap a kid and go see this movie.
Right. Again.
You
don't want to go through all that again. That was a pain in the ass. The rest of us there, FBI is coming to our door every day. Have you seen this man?
I'll put him back.
Don't know who that is, officer. Never seen him before. Corey Coleman, never heard of him.
What? I placed him back in his home when we were done watching the movie. But yeah, no, you're a good salesman, man. Because, you know, even with you trying to say that this movie's a rental, I'm like, hey, you told me a lot of stuff. Maybe it's all that history about Jackie Chan. I just want to see this movie
now. I'm exciting you about Jackie Chan.
Yeah.
If you like Jackie Chan, you should watch his classic movies, Dragons Forever being the, you know, the, oh my God, you have to see this movie of all his movies. But, you know, it isn't bad for what it is. It's just nothing as an adult you should bother going out to the theater to see either,
because
it is a film for very small children, and matched by a few saving graces and never quite hitting as low on the ladder of these things as they would do if Vin Diesel or The Rock was doing them, you know. So yeah, it's a rental coming full circle again.
Okay,
it's a rental unless you're watching it inside my head when that actress is on screen.
It's still a rental. It just depends on what store you're renting it from.
Then it's not better than sex. It's just sex.
Good one. You know, Jackie Chan, I guess if you worked with Chris Tucker, then you can get through anything.
Yeah.
You know, fuck the Chinese opera, you know. He's like, yay, Jackie Chan!
We're going to do Rush Hour 4. Can you break my hip again, please, instead?
I am international spy on loan to the CIA.
Cool.